The KTM Adventure Rally is a non-competitive global event held at epic locations across the globe. It also allows like-minded riders to share their experiences, knowledge, and the opportunity to ride roads, tracks, and trails that nobody would imagine existed. Sitting at 300 meters above sea level, Quillan is a small French town seated at the foothills of the Pyrenees Mountains near the river Aude. With a population of fewer than 3,500 people, it is a true backcountry gem, boasting one of the most spectacular landscapes in France. With only 150 stops available, the fifth edition of the European KTM Adventure Rally sold out in less than 24 hours, with a surprising number of riders from Central and South America. In fact, over 24 countries were represented at the rally, proving that adventurers aren't afraid of traveling to explore new destinations.
I come from Scotland.
We're from Holland.
I'm from Russia. I will come to the event, even if it's in South Africa.
I live in California. I've been in the States in many rallies.
I've driven about 1,500 kilometers.
1,800 kilometers.
I'm coming from Denmark, more than 2,000 kilometers.
All the way from Malta.
I've come from sort of like southwest Turkey, so it took me, I had to get here, it took me 4.5 days. 3,700 kilometers.
I'm so happy to be there again.
KTM Adventure Rally participants are well looked after when it comes to ensuring their machines are ready to tackle the trails. All motorcycles need to pass a technical check to ensure they are ready to hit the road. For that reason, expert KTM mechanics are on hand to offer advice and do repairs where necessary.
We have day zero, as we call it. Day zero is registration. We do the tech check on all the bikes. So every customer has to show up in our tent. And we have a quick look over his bike, check wheel bearings, headstock bearings, brake pads, suspension, all that stuff. And if we find some issues, we fix it.
Also, with many riders traveling long distances to attend the KTM Adventure Rally, they will undoubtedly need new tires. Thankfully, our expert team is on hand to replace road-worn tires with more suitable rubber. For those riders looking to hit the trails on their own, KTM Rally experts are on hand to help riders set up their GPS devices, with an exclusive opportunity to attend a workshop from Dakar legend and ex-team manager KTM Dakar team, Jordi Viladoms.
I guess I'm here because of the connection of KTM with the Dakar Rally.
Jordi Viladoms' workshop on navigation presents a great learning opportunity for the riders taking on the trails on their own. With all his experience, Jordi created the Viladoms Navigation School and has nurtured some of the best rally riders currently in action.
I came here to help a little bit the guys, to do some a small briefing about how to navigate, about safety, how to ride this with a GPS, and so to do some advice and try to bring some experience from Dakar to the guys.
A small selection of only 20 riders has the opportunity to join expert guided tours based on their skill levels. For this, riders have to undergo a skills test in a nearby area, with another KTM legend and adventure product manager, Joachim Sauer, assessing each rider's skill.
The goal would be to have same skill level riders in one group, so you don't have a fast and a slow rider. It just makes it a lot more interesting and a lot more fun.
The KTM Adventure Rally is proud to have a select number of KTM legends on its ambassador panel, namely, six-time World Enduro champion and four-time ISDE winner with Italy, Giovanni Sala. Renowned French Dakar victory contender and Trans-Anatolia champion, Xavier de Soultrait. Two-time E2 Euro World champion and three-time ISDE winner with France, Johnny Aubert. Greg Gordine, who famously tackled the Iron Giant on a 2022 KTM 890 Adventure R. Paolo Cataneo and Johnny Nice, who have both traveled the world on two wheels. And lastly, key speaker Joey Evans, from Para to Dakar fame.
It's my first participation. A friend of mine did a KTM rally in Greece last year and he said, you have to go. So here I am. A bit anxious because I'm beginner, but I mean, yeah, I'm here to learn and to enjoy.
It's the fourth time I've been to the Adventure Rally. It's the spirit of the group.
It's such a great atmosphere to come back and meet the old friends every year again. It's such a nice event.
Our heart orange is KTM.
This is a dream.
I want to try this adventure because I look a video on YouTube and it was very funny.
Ah, what an opportunity to be at the Adventure Rally. Fantastic. Always wanted to do it. Obviously, COVID has stopped us, but to be here with my friends, make new friends, and of course, ride KTM is fantastic.
Well, I think it's pretty amazing to see all these happy faces.
Good afternoon, Orange family. Nah. Look, I know you guys have traveled far, you're probably tired, but that's sucked. Should we try that again? Good afternoon, Orange family. There we go. Well, guys, welcome to the 2022 European KTM Adventure Rally.
Day one presents riders with 240 kilometers of epic landscapes and around 6 hours in the saddle, with riders climbing 4,000 meters in elevation. The night has brought a bit of rain, keeping the dust very low and making the tracks a little more challenging for the participants. Muddy tracks and deep paddles await the riders, who are ready to kick their side stands up at 7:30 a.m. sharp.
It's a Christmas day! Ready to rain!
They haven't even left the comfort of camp when they turn off the tarmac and join a twisty trail with a challenging muddy hill greeting them. The loop continues with another 40 kilometers of 4x4 trails, switching from sandy-colored gravel to the typical red soil characteristic of the area. The riders finally arrive at the first special test of the three-day rally. Bemused and quite excited, the riders find a motocross track awaiting them.
Track dry a little bit and now it's just perfect to wide open and have a lot of pleasure.
Luckily, Ready to Race KTM ambassadors Xavier de Soultrait, Greg Gordine, and Johnny Aubert are on hand to offer advice and showcase the capabilities of their KTM adventure bikes. All the riders accept the challenge and ride at least one lap around the specially prepared MX track. After having lunch with the 11th century Chateau de Carabus standing proudly in the distance,
all day, the best ever.
All riders take to the road once again and climb a rocky hill which brings them to the foot of the famous castle 728 meters above sea level. Another 35 kilometers of relatively easy tracks await our riders, with the Gorges de Galamousse making itself known. This asphalt road was quite literally carved from the valley in 1890 by the men of nearby villages and twists its way down a 2 kilometer stretch of perilous ribbon-like tarmac. While the KTM Adventure Rally is a non-competitive event, 30 lucky riders are chosen to compete in an entertaining slow race. Here, the slowest rider to complete the course wins a special prize, with penalties given to anyone who falls over or puts a foot down. With guest stars like Greg Gordine, Xavier de Soultrait, and Johnny Aubert, all the signed up participants gave it a shot.
Very impressive.
We expected it to be good, but this was way beyond expectation.
We had sand, we had rocks, we had little jumps. Super cool.
Pretty wild.
It was a good first day.
Amazing.
The best day I've ever had riding.
It's fantastic, but I am absolutely knackered.
Yes, obviously I'm ready for the day two, and tomorrow we'll see again.
On day two, riders have a fairly short day with only 180 kilometers. But don't be fooled, they're in for a challenging route, made even harder by the previous night's downpour. It's expected to take the riders 5 hours to complete as they conquer challenging hills with a 4,300 meter elevation gain to reach their stopover at an alpine resort. Riders face a challenging forest trail. The ground is sodden and soft from the previous night's rain, with significant mud channels and water puddles. Some rocky parts catch a few of the lesser experienced riders out, with a tight uphill curve and a steep ramp claiming a few more riders. Thankfully, the route opens up to an easy dirt road to the top of the ski slopes.
This is adventure, eh?
So, oh, it's technical.
Oh.
great fun, great pleasure to be here.
Catching some fresh air before descending all the way down a single trail in a forest in the direction of the next special test. Another surprise special stage as the riders come face to face with a big enduro loop put together by the local enduro club. Long uphill with off-camber tight turns sets a real challenge for orange bleeders eager to test their adventure machines. All the adventure riders decided to give it a shot by picking hard or soft lines, with KTM ambassadors Greg Gordine and Johnny Aubert showing them how it's done on the KTM 890 Adventure R. After the special stage, the riders make their way back to base camp with a steady descent from Route du Portel Quillan.
Day two was awesome.
The off-road tracks are excellent.
Perfect day, starting in the morning, crashed into the tree, but afterward it was perfect.
Never had a real hard day, but today was his hardest in his life, I think.
Very tough.
Learn a lot. Fuchio, you learn so much. Big discovery for me was the mud. A good learning curve for me, good tips from the guide. It was really great, like you could feel the bike in a new way. So.
New for me to feel the balance in that high speed.
I'm really happy to be here. It's awesome. You know, the organization is so perfectly. I'm glad to be here.
These are awesome. The mechanics are awesome. They just change my fork. Awesome time. Awesome pace. Awesome food. Awesome time.
And I want you to think about what is your dream adventure. And so I had a dream growing up that I wanted to race the Dakar Rally 10 years. After breaking my back, had a lot of scary moments and things. I want you to think about what are the things that you want to do with your life, whether it's riding or whether it's just taking any kind of risk in your life, because when you take those risks, you have an adventure. And adventure is good things and it's bad things. Sometimes you hit a camel and sometimes you give it the horns. But one day I hope you guys get to the end of your life and you just say, I had an adventure. Thank you guys.
Last and shortest day of the KTM Adventure Rally sees the riders traverse 140 kilometers over 4 hours. These are faster tracks compared to the previous days. has a special surprise for the riders. The brand new 2023 KTM 890 Adventure R is launched simultaneously in the USA and France. This cements the KTM Adventure Rally as a real global event, with simultaneous launches across territories and riders sharing the same experiences across different time zones.
It's an incredible beast, guys.
Now I have to take it.
Look at it, it's just perfect.
My finances are in trouble. Absolutely, I'm gonna get one as soon as possible.
With the tracks lined by vast French vineyards, the riders head to their last lunch stop.
We worked since more or less 10 months to organize this event. I grew up in this area, so it's really emotional to join my real family, my friend, and my KTM family.
KTM Adventure Rally is actually about the spirit and camaraderie that happens between the riders here.
And when I think about the spirit of an adventure rally, what it is it's people from all different backgrounds, all different countries, all different types of riding terrain, and they all come together. We share stories, we ride together, we help each other pull bikes up hills and all sorts of stuff, and it's just this big orange family hanging out, having fun.
The best part is the orange community.
After a quick lunch break with paella at a local resort, the riders head through a gorgeous valley, littered with single tracks, with the final special test marking the end of three epic days of riding. In one of the most amazing locations ever, the last and final special test takes place at an abandoned shooting range. Here, the riders have to tackle a challenging set of up and down hills, connected with very tight corners. As always, all the riders decided to give it a try, with a benchmark of 15 minutes set for the best, smoothest time.
Yeah, it was super nice and super crazy to meet all of these guys. I was invited like an ambassador for the first time. That's my first KTM Adventure Rally. It was absolutely fantastic.
It was my first experience at the KTM Adventure Rally, but it was really amazing. Really 3 days, really fantastic. With great people and good events. It just was really funny to ride with all of them.
I find a good spirit and good family and everyone was kind of me. We speak about Dakar, about their adventures, their travel.
Final impression is just amazing. It was really good. It is so fast over always when we start, and it's over because it's so beautiful and great, and the people, I really love it.
I can tell it was the best rally in my life.
Great experience.
The enduro and the motocross tracks were superb.
The experience, it was great.
And a lot of new friends.
I really appreciate all details that KTM have done, because it's very, very smooth for the customers. Easy to see, easy to ride, easy to know what to do.
And we had to ride in the dust and in the mud and then in the sun. So we were riding on all conditions. It was good and it was great.
Much better than expected. It was my first time. I have been 35 years racing motocross and blah blah, and yesterday was one of the best days of my life. It's true, because I told everybody.
I was a beginner 3 days ago. I learned a lot from zero to be able to finish the 3 days. All the support, all the advice by the ambassadors, but also by any bikers, just a question, and it was so great. I was doubting before starting, saying, is it really serious to go when you don't know how to go up and down? And I'm here, it worked, it was fun. I can only wait for next year.
Absolutely fantastic. The KTM Brotherhood here is off the scale. No politics, just KTM riding. Had a little spill, went down the hill, I couldn't recover it. We ended up with Russians, Dutch, German, Spanish, Colombians, all come together, pulled me up out the hill, got me on the road again, and it was fantastic. So yeah, worth every penny. I would recommend anyone to do a KTM adventure.
Come here, guys, it's very good.
It's a very good doctor. I'm very pleased. Top.
Well, the event this year improved as well a lot because of the keep, the tent, the people together. So I think it's nice in a way that you stick together, have fun together, because people are so nice. Well, you see that there is a lot behind the scene, and fantastic done. Actually, the event is super.
I hope we can repeat soon, because it's really, really fun.
On the final night, the riders were met with a raging bonfire, cold beer, and great food. They were treated to a prize-giving ceremony, with awards being given out to selected individuals, like the oldest and youngest riders, the riders who had traveled the furthest to join the rally, and more. This made for the perfect end to three epic days in the Sep. Experience the 2023 KTM Adventure Rally for yourself? Visit KTM.com.